With an inquisitive stare, the viewer tapped the robust chin in a thoughtful manner, gazing at the monitor with one solitary but resonating question piercing the stillness of their pristine contemplation. A question for the ages that would define the turn of a faded century, and would decide the fate of the next fateful generation to inherit the fate of the fateful Earth's fate. From the brilliance of our sun-swept home to the cold blackness of space, a single pondering notion plagued the vast and fruitful mind of the audience. They all questioned, "What the fuck is Opoona?" Released for the Wii in 2007, Opoona imparts an important lesson: that a little bit of charm and polish can go a long way. As can marketing research. I can't find the exact figures nowadays, but I remember seeing this game sold about 10,000 copies worldwide, total, a year after its release. If I released a no-budget indie game on Steam, I'd be disappointed by those sales numbers. So take note, game developers, if your target audience plays video games, they're probably gonna prioritize Mario. Opoona ultimately fell victim to terrible marketing, which is a shame because otherwise I think this game could have met with moderate success, or maybe even great success, who knows. It was a really fun, creative experience from beginning to end for me, so let's talk about it. Opoona is juggling a lot of mechanics all at once. It's trying to be a fast-paced RPG, an exploration game, and a life simulator, similar to Harvest Moon, all at once. And while it never completely fails at any of these tasks, it certainly stumbles. I think that's a nice way of putting it. This is a flavor of review I think every critic should tackle at some point. The final product of Opoona begs the question, how much can the good make up for the shortcomings? Well, let's find out. The game starts with Opoona and his adorable little family traveling to the human planet of Landroll for a vacation. Opoona is an alien known as a Tizian, which is basically a chubby little space paladin. I just want to pinch their glorious little cheeks. His whole race strives to protect the world from rogues, manifestations of weakness and aggression in people's hearts. All Tizians have a natural weapon known as energy bonbons. Yes, bonbons. You fight things with a bonbon. It's only gonna get cuter from here, so if you need to pause the video and wrestle the nearest grizzly bear to get your testosterone back up, I'll understand. Continuing the cuteness, the tutorial appears in the form of various adorable little Pomeranian puppies. If you examine these puppies, their name tags actually have optional tutorials, which I think is a nice touch. You can skip these tutorials if you feel so inclined. Plus, there's a battle simulator that allows you to get some practice with the game's very unique battle system, which I'll discuss more later. I like how all of this is optional, and all of it is pretty quick and efficient. The game also goes out of its way of setting up this nice, funny, charming family dynamic of Opoona being kind of a lazy, fat, big brother, and he needs to look out for his siblings more, and all that junk, and you know, that's great and all. Maybe they should have actually capitalized on it, because you see, the family immediately gets separated right after this opening is finished. This sets up our premise overall. Opoona needs to adjust to the new society of Landroll, learn more about it, attribute to society in some kind of meaningful way, he needs to get a job, do all that jazz, and, you know, it is an interesting premise. It's a fun combination of this sort of alternate reality life simulation combined with a strategic RPG. The premise is fine, but you introduced the only interesting characters right at the start and then you separate all of them. That is not good storytelling. Due to the escape pods, the kids seem to survive the landing just fine, but the parents are rendered unconscious because they were a victim of the direct crash. Since we didn't have a lot of time with those characters, we don't really feel any sense of loneliness or desperation because of this revelation. Opoona just hops into work, becomes a Landroll Ranger, which is someone who combats local rogues, and that's about it. There's not a lot of emotional weight to the story until way, way, way later, which is definitely something of a shortcoming for a game that spends so much time talking to you. There are some optional friendships on the side, but none of these really go anywhere, and they all mainly facilitate just larger, more interesting quests. Their stories are not particularly interesting in and of themselves, though some of them can be a little bit funny. And the side characters in the story are incredibly boring, one-note tropes, and you can see their motivations and twists coming from a mile away. It's a shame, too, because this game did have a trio of well-developed, interesting characters, and then it barely makes use of them. Opoona is alone for a very big portion of the game, then Paulina is put on a bus for an extremely long portion of the story, and once all three siblings get together, they barely talk to each other. It's definitely a waste of potential. These three really could have been funny. It's like if Ed, Edd and Eddy's first two seasons did not have the Eds interact with each other. At all. Does that sound like good use of your assets? But that is one of very few of my nitpicks, and for the most part, this game does everything right. For example, the setting itself is really fascinating. The world of Landrill feels like a living, breathing character. It's a very well-developed world. Right from the start of the game, there's a lot of lore, a lot of backstory, a lot of different hobbies for you to participate in. There's pet shops, there's animal reserves, there's art galleries. There's a lot of interesting stuff going on for you to explore, and quite a lot of it is optional, which is a nice touch. You can focus on whatever you want to focus on. The game also provides excellent feedback for exploration. As you develop various different friendships, you can develop new abilities, new talents, new interests, new hobbies. You can unlock new jobs, which in turn allow you to explore new areas and facilities throughout the various different domes. It's cool stuff. Exploring always leads to more stuff to explore and more things to do. The exploration is probably one of the most well-handled aspects of Opoona. There's even little secret hidden codes for you to find, and if you find certain amounts, you can spend points on various different unlockable weapon upgrades and other items. And of course, I would be much remiss to not address the, unique character designs. They're certainly memorable, I'll give them that, especially this guy. I'm not happy! I mean, just because I won the first prize in the lottery doesn't mean I'm happy! But wait, there's more! We got a lady whose hair could be considered a deadly weapon. We got Waluigi. We got Ben Franklin. We got Lady Gaga? She even says things that Lady Gaga would say. But wait a minute. Something doesn't add up. If this game came out in 2007, and Lady Gaga came out in 2008, and Lady Gaga, well, came out in 2010, then did I just make a gay joke? For the most part, I really enjoyed the game's art style overall, even if some of the character designs are a little questionable. But the real highlight for me here is actually the gameplay, and that leads us to the control scheme.
This game has one of the most unique control schemes of any game I've ever seen. For one thing, you can actually control the entire game using just the nunchuck. That's right, you see this Wiimote? You see all these buttons and all this functionality? Fuck it, you don't need it. You can control the entire game just like this. Why? I don't fucking know. It's pointless. It's kind of cool, but pointless. Jazz hands.
They don't really use the unique control scheme in any kind of meaningful way. I think Bayonetta had a one-handed control scheme too, but that might have been for other reasons. The control scheme is as such because the game puts a lot of emphasis on the control stick, especially in its battle system. The combat is actually one of the most engaging aspects of Opoona. It's quite possibly my favorite part of it, which is very surprising for such a cutesy little game. And the reason for this is the emphasis on timing, prediction, and positioning, as opposed to very typical menu-based combat. You see, you can aim at one enemy at a time, and determine the angle at which you attack that enemy by rotating the control stick in different directions. This hurls out the energy bonbon of whichever sibling you're currently controlling, and it rapidly switches the control over to the next sibling once you're done. What's really cool about this system is it's fast, it's kinetic, and it's extremely varied. And it allows for a lot of interesting strategy, because you can actually aim your bonbon so it attacks multiple enemies in one go if you have the right equipment on. You can also equip all kinds of customizable elemental attacks, special effects, self-healing, cool stuff like that. There's a lot of variety in the fundamental battle system, and it's a solid RPG on top of that, with a nice progression of challenge that never feels like it gets too overwhelming. The difficulty curve is fair, and the game fully acknowledges that it has a very unique system, so there's plenty of completely optional tutorials, which is a very nice touch. You can skip them if you feel so inclined. I also really enjoyed how the game would occasionally place things like bombs or self-destructing enemies on the battlefield, so you have to angle your attack in a specific way to avoid detonating them and getting your siblings hurt. It's pretty creative, I gotta say. It added a lot of variety to the system. Plus, the enemies are never in the same position twice, even if you're fighting the same enemy, so you have to try different angles. It's really cool stuff. I like it. I had fun with the battles literally from beginning to end, and the boss fights are very creative, even though there's very few boss fights. Plus, all of the enemy designs and names are just so creative. I mean, look at these little guys with the guitar heads. They're called Radio Gigi, like the Queen song Radio Gaga. Isn't that adorable? And when they play a song, they die. They instantaneously die. Is that because Freddie Mercury? Is this the real life? Is this just really completely uncalled for? Just did not need to fucking happen. Putting aside my trauma, this game has two other strengths besides the combat that kept me wanting more. The exploration of the incredibly deep world and the charming presentation. Look at some of these visuals. While they're not pushing the technical limitations of the Wii, which already wasn't a powerhouse to begin with, there's a very nice quality to all of the visuals. It's a little bit disappointing that this game does not display in progressive scan, meaning it doesn't really run at maximum capacity of most HD TVs nowadays, but it still looks very nice because of the cel-shaded style and the attention to detail given to the large variety of environments. This is a game that gives me the distinct impression they did not want to make repetitive worlds. All the songs, all the places, all the color schemes, they're varied. There's a lot of nice lighting tricks. It's very fun to explore this world, and that's what you're going to be doing for about half of your gameplay time, just walking around learning more about the world. It definitely suits the vacation gone wrong plotline. It also makes Opoona a really good game for curious kids, and there's not really a lot of great kids games coming out nowadays. After a few hours of letting you get your bearings, you can ignore the main story for a little while if you so desire, and participate in various mini-games, side quests, optional areas, optional boss fights, cool stuff like that. It's very fun. You can also take a cute little Pomeranian for a walk. Probably the best part of the entire game. Though I'll admit, I wish that the mini-games had a bit more substance to them. It's a shame since the combat itself and the world exploring is so fulfilling. Once again, I think it's worth noting that I've seen this game on sale for like 10 bucks on Amazon, and for that price, you're getting quite a lot of content. This is a full-scale legitimate RPG, despite its initial impressions. It really is a very deep battle system with a great rich lore, a fascinating world to explore, great art direction, especially with the backgrounds and enemy designs, and while the character designs are a little bit questionable, that really is just personal taste, and I'll be the first to admit that. And with all that being said, I can now spend the rest of this video raving like a lunatic about how beautiful this soundtrack is. Like all things I try to achieve in life, this review took way too long to make, but it was a blast because it gave me an excuse to listen to this music constantly. The sound is varied and has a really unique instrumentation, relying on a combination of real instruments like guitars and saxophones, and soothing low-key drum pads and synths. It's sort of a soothing electronic jazz lounge fusion of world music. It all comes together in a beautiful way that perfectly enhances the mood of every situation. For example, the Blue Desert creates a great sense of peaceful exploration with its slow, mellow tone, which goes great with the blue visuals. Fairy Grove is appropriately mystical and mysterious, and can even be haunting at times, yet it occasionally shifts into something more inviting and hopeful, which is nice because it comes at a very pivotal moment in the plot when the status quo has been challenged. And all the different battle themes are appropriately intense and invigorating, suiting the urgency of the time limit battle system that greatly rewards quickly dispatching enemies in an efficient order. It's nice and hectic. Overall, the soundtrack is really creative and varied. It's great. In fact, it was made by the same guy who composed the Final Fantasy XII soundtrack? Huh. Talent. Overall, Opoona's extremely underrated. I think you should check it out. I mean, come on, don't you want to play as a character who looks like this and sounds like this when he walks? You know you want to. I mean, I'd buy an amiibo of this guy. And that's why, as a final rating, I'm giving Opoona a I need to clean my apartment and find the original box out of 10. And now, I'd like to leave you with a song. Opoona Reunia. What a wonderful phrase. Ain't seen a planet this corrupt since Samus blew up phase. It means no worries of Disney copyright claims. Well, hello there. Thanks, as always, for watching. Now, I want to give a big shout-out to the patrons that help keep this show running. I am amazed by how quickly the Patreon has actually gathered steam, and I am really grateful. I cannot emphasize that enough. As the number of patrons increase, I can focus on making more episodes and can afford to get better recording equipment, and that means more videos for you guys, and a larger variety of videos, and higher quality videos. So, if you want to support the show, consider clicking the link to become a patron. The show will always be free, I'm always going to keep it that way, and I love making it, but any support is appreciated, even a dollar helps. Thanks as always, guys. I cannot express enough how amazing it is that people are willing to support my silly little freak show, so thank you again. Now, if you want to help spread the show, you know what to do at this point. Like, share, subscribe, and infect the internet with my pretentious rants. I'm a shameless sellout, I'm fully aware of it. Oh, and by the way, did you know that you can vote for Smash Bros. Characters now? Isn't that awesome? I actually voted for Midna. She's this character from Twilight Princess, like one of the Legend of Zelda games. I think I talked about that franchise like once or twice on this channel before. I've been thinking about Midna and Twilight Princess a lot lately. I don't know. I wonder why. Anyway, if you want to check out previous episodes of the show, you click right here, and don't forget, subscribe for more. Bye! Thank you. Why didn't you click something?